Good day from Chem Help ASAP. Let's revisit the use of alkoxides as bases for the E2 reaction. We have two E2 reactions on the screen, and both use alkoxides for the base in the reaction. Both reactions use the same alkyl halide, a secondary halide. In the top reaction, the base is sodium methoxide. While methoxide can be an SN2 nucleophile, a secondary halide is sufficiently hindered that the expected outcome is instead an E2. The solvent is an alcohol, methanol. Protic solvents typically favor the E2 reaction. We have multiple beta hydrogens. Let's draw them in. For an alkoxide like methoxide, we remove the more hindered beta hydrogen. And get the Saytzeff product, the more highly substituted alkene. In the bottom reaction, the conditions are much the same. The alkoxide base, t-butoxide, is used in an alcohol solvent, t-butanol, to give an E2 product. The steric hindrance of t-butoxide, the classic bulky base, leads to removal of a less hindered beta hydrogen. And the formation of the Hofmann product, the less highly substituted alkene. The regiochemistry of the elimination has changed based on the bulkiness of the base. The alkoxides in these reactions were almost certainly formed through reaction of an alcohol with sodium hydride or a metal like sodium or potassium. In SN2 reactions, we often show the deprotonation step. For E2 reactions, the deprotonation step is almost never shown. The chemistry of the base is less important because the base is not incorporated into the structure of the final product. Methoxide is not incorporated into the structure of the final product. T-butoxide is not part of the product. Therefore, the base is almost always placed as a reagent over the arrow, while the alkyl halide is the featured starting material to the left of the arrow.